1982, breaking Bobby Hull's record, where Grant Mulvey scored 5 goals in 1 game, and Michel Goulet became the third Blackhawk to break the 500 barrier.
Goulet racing, he's got a break! Goulet for number 500!
The tradition was alive in 1991 when the Hawks finished first in the league, capturing their first President's Trophy. It was also in 91 when the stadium roared as the world watched and Chicago draped itself in red, white, and blue in support of the American troops in the Gulf War.
As loud as they were and as electrifying as they were and the chills that they shot through everybody's spine, it was tremendous.
The anthem salute was the Gray Lady's finest hour.
So I met General Schwarzkopf. He said, I've never seen anything like it. He said, I couldn't read the war and I was in my bunker. And he said, I had to play to all my 541,000 troops. So I thought it was the greatest tribute to American armed services that I have seen.
The stadium sparkled for the NHL's 75th anniversary season as the Hawks honored a proud past. When the Blackhawks won 11 straight games in the 1992 playoffs, the madhouse on Madison Street welcomed another Stanley Cup Finals as fans witnessed Captain Dirk Graham rise to the challenge.
Now Noonan out of the corner, centering, they score! The hat trick for Graham! Dirk Graham! 3 straight goals for one team, and Dirk Graham has done it! And the hat come cascading down from the stadium rafters. We're tied at 3.
Throughout the stadium's grandest moments, one element held constant: the enthusiasm of Blackhawks fans.
It's been such a part of our whole family's life, you know, that we spent a lot of time there. I have a lot of memories, and it's just like moving out of a home that you lived in for 40 years. It's got to be sad. And it'll be sad that last day when they lower the banners and play the taps. There won't be a dry eye in the place.
And so the tradition beats on, with the names of Balfour, Chelios, and Roenick added to the likes of Esposito, Makita, and Hull. They are all part of a place that has stood as Chicago's world stage for generations, a place that has touched us all with laughter and song, with purpose and passion, a place that was home to heroes and champions and a lifetime of memories. And when her doors close forever, we'll remember the moments of triumph and of joy. We'll remember the thrills we all shared. But in our hearts, above all, we will remember the roar.
Think of seasons that must end. See the rivers rise and fall. They will rise and fall again. Everything must die again, like an ocean to a shore, like a river to a
a stream. It's the famous final scene. How you tried to make it work. Did you really think it could? How you tried to make it last. Did you really think it would? Like a guest who stayed too long. Now it's finally time to leave. Yes, it's finally time to leave. Take it calmly and serene. It's the famous final scene. Have all been read, and you knew them all by heart. Now you move toward the door. Here it comes, the hardest part. Try to handle love the road. Never be arranged. As the light fades from the screen, from the famous final scene.